Jai Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Sri Gaura Bhaktivinoda. Hari Hari Jai Jai. Thank you. Thanks so much again for this opportunity, for this meeting. Well, I feel very, very fortunate because of being in contact with all of you. thank you very much. as all of us, we know, Sadhu Sangha is so important, most important, is the biggest benediction. because when we are in contact with devotees, with sadhus, we are obliged to act in the right way. By the simple, situation or condition to be with a devotee, you must have a pure life. You are obliged to have good conduct, to act in the nice way. So this means that we can see through this that devotee, which is simply presence, they are purifying. They are purifying everything. For that reason, they are called the Tirtha Kurvanti. They are creating tirthas. So by their own presence, they are creating sacred places. they are purifying our countries, it is said. Now I'm looking after this. Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, those devotees who are peaceful, it is by Nisinga. Lord Nisinga is saying, Srimad Bhagavatam 7:10:19. Yatra yatra chamat bhakta, wherever my devotees are going, prashanta, samadarshina, devotees who are very peaceful and who are equal to everyone, to everybody. Equanimity, no? Those who has equanimity. sadhava, those who are saintly persons. excuse me. Change that. This light behind is not good. There is good, better. excuse me. So we can see, you know, how Nisinghadeva, he loves so much his devotees. He's glorifying his devotees. As Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also, he was giving full potency to his devotees in order them to do the same thing, the same service that he himself was doing, delivering, you know, everybody. So in this way, Lord Krishna is always trying to put the devotees in his own level. We are from same level, we can say. So, yatra yatra chamad bhakta. This also means my devotees, they will be everywhere. As Narada Muni, he's going everywhere. So in this way, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, he wants to bless the whole universe. Because all this universe, even so it is material universe, all these things, but it is also his universe. No, it is Lord Jagannath's universe, so he loves also this place, because in this place we have Bhumi, Vrindavan, we have Yamuna, Ganges, all these things, all these sacred places. So here also in this material world, we are inside Krishna's heart. It is said like this. He said that the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that the space, it is Krishna's heart. As we know, we are always inside Krishna, because Krishna is earth, Krishna is air, Krishna is water. So we are embraced by Krishna. Antar Bahir, Krishna is inside, Krishna is outside. Bahir Nisinha, Hridayen Nisinha. Bahir means outside. So, Lord Nisinha is outside us, is inside us. Hridaye Nisinha. So, okay. So, we must be like this because Lord Nisinha is glorifying his devotee. Even so, we can say it was only one devotee, Prahlad Maharaj. At this place, he was almost alone. Yes, he was also preaching to his schoolmates, but still he was alone, we can say. So even so, if we are alone, Srila Srila Maharaj says like this: sometimes you will be alone, sometimes you will be among many devotees. Doesn't matter. We must go ahead, because actually we will be always among devotees. If you are chanting Hare Krishna, if you are trying to serve, you are never alone. So yatra yatra chamad bhakta, wherever my devotees they are going, I am with them. Prashanta, samadarshina qualities that we must have. Be very, very peaceful. Be full of love for everybody, for everyone. We must be very, very strong in this point, in this matter. I must love. I must become love. This is bhakti, the bhakta position. Srila Bhakti Prabhupada Maharaj, he was saying, devotees are Krishna's heart. Krishna's heart is full of love. So when somebody see a devotee, he must think, oh, there is Krishna's heart. Krishna's heart is here. It's walking here, it's going through, it's in this place. Kripa Sindhu. Kripa Sindhu Vyayavacha. Manchakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyayavacha. In this way, devotees are glorified. Kripa Sindhu. Oceans of mercy. Same thing we say about Krishna, about Lord Chaitanya. So it is like this. Kali Yuga is, in some ways, the worst, no? The worst yuga, the worst era. So Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, I must become more merciful. In the worst situation, more kind. It is like this. So this is very nice. And because the devotees, they are taking God's qualities. Devotees are only interested on transcendental qualities. Because somebody may say, oh, he has the quality gaining a lot of money. He can gain a lot of money. He has this quality. Or he has a very good memory. Or he has very nice body. Or he is very famous. Some qualities that everybody are looking after in this world. But we want only sadguna, transcendental qualities. And Bhagavan Sri Krishna, he is sadguna vishista. He is the owner of most special transcendental qualities. And devotees, they are taking from this ocean. Like this. For example, in this world, people, they are looking after gold mines, minas de oro mines, gold mines, or copper, or petrol, things like this. But the devotees, they are looking after qualities minds. And this is Sisi Radha Krishna. They are these minds of qualities, a fountain head of qualities. Surprising qualities. As a same Lord Brahma, he was surprised, no? How you delivered which putana? Why? How can you do this? How could you did this? And well, all these things. Jagai Madai, all these things. So devotees, they must be relief, fountain heads of relief. Eka Jagat Bandhus. They are the real friends of everyone. And in this way, as Lord Brahma is saying, Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena Santasadaiva Riyayesu Viloka Yanti. We must put love in our eyes. Our eyes must be full of love. whoever you see, you must say, you must sing, oh, I love you. You are my brother. You are my sister. I love you. Oh, I wish the best for you. This is very, very nice to do like this. It is very healthy and it's very nice. Sometimes I'm trying to do it. Many times I'm forgetting to do it. Because one is so lazy, you know, so conditioned. But I think it is a practice that we must do. As we know, Goswamis, you know, they were bowing. They were bowing down before everybody. So this is a way of offering obeisances to everybody. Premanjana Churita, because this is a very important sloka of Brahma Samhita, because here Lord Brahma in this sloka is teaching us how can we see Syama Sundar in our hearts, everybody's hearts. So you will be always seeing Syama Sundar. Imagine, it is too much. Hare Krishna is too much blessings. How can I do this? Through knowledge, through tapasya, through renunciation. No, simply through love. But Lord Brahma is saying prema, prema anjan. And this is the highest quality that we must pray for. I am begging for this prema. Because through this prema, I will love everybody. This is the king of all qualities, the father and mother of all qualities, this prema. So this prema anjana, to see through love. I was thinking these ways some time ago, and after some days I read that Srila Haridas Thakur, he was doing like this. So I found this support from the highest authority, again from our Lord Brahma. He was doing like this. I read, no, I seen that in Bhagavad, in Chaitanya Bhagavad, maybe Chaitanya Bhagavad, said that when Srila Haridas Thakur, he was seeing somebody, he was thinking, he was praying, my dear Lord, please make him a devotee. Oh, when I read that, oh, this is better than how I was doing. Because I was only thinking, oh yes, I love you and I wish the best for you. Have a good day. Have a good day. Sarve bhavantu sukhina. Be happy. All of you be happy. Sarve bhavantu sukhina. Sarve shantu nirayamaya. Nobody suffer, please suffer any disease. Sarve shantu nirayamaya. Sarve badrani pashantu. I wish that all of you will see only auspicious things. all these things. This is very worth. Remember these slokas. So we must try this thing in this way, no? To have good feelings, because this is the nature of the transcendental world. Transcendental world, there are only good feelings. There are no bad feelings. Here in this world, almost only bad feelings. Especially in Kali Yuga, you know, the yuga of fighting, Rinya, no? Kali, fighting, always fighting, discussing. But as we are seeing every day, Kali Yuga Pavana, Kali Vayanashi, Kali Vayanashi, Kali Yuga Pavana, Mahaprabhu is purifying the influence of Kali through this love, through our preaching work, preaching service. Srila Haryastaku was thinking in this way, please become a devotee. Oh, we must sing, oh. Srila Haryastaku, he was thinking in this way. So I must serve him. I must try in such a way that everyone that I meet, he will be a devotee. I will try him to become a devotee. Hare Krishna. Premanjana Churita Bhakti Virochanen. Bhakti Virochanen. Bhakti. This is the transcendental world, the world of Bhakti. So Krishna is speaking in this way. Everything depends on our nature, in our bhava. Mad bhava, Bhagavan Sri Krishna say, you must reach my bhava, mad bhava. You must have my same feelings. Because if you want to be with me, you must feel as I feel. You cannot come to me only to discuss with me, to be being against me. No, but it doesn't work. Everybody stay in his own group. Those who are always challenging, okay, you can stay with those who are always challenging. those who like to disturb, they will be with the same kind of people. And those who want to serve, they are different. So Krishna is giving also this training. Begin to serve Hare Krishna. Ahai Tuki, with no personal motive. Serve only because of love. This is the beginning, because we are so egoistic. Or we are always full of fears. How I will serve with no remuneration? No. So we are taking this risk. Krishna becomes very happy. Oh, he is confident. He believes on me. He's putting all his faith on me. He has been cheated so many times. But now he's putting his faith on me. I cannot fail. Nane bhakta pranasyati. My devotee will be never vanquished. I promise. This is my promise. We can say that this is almost the only promise that he's giving Gita. Of course, he gives a lot of promise in Gita. If you think in me, you will come to me. If you worship me, you will come to me. If you are full of, if you are free from envy, you will understand all this because you are anaga, because you are free from sins. So you will become perfect. Krishna is speaking in this way. But, and also, yes, if you think on me, Marmanava, Marvaktu. So, Pratignya, I promise, I love you. And you will be never vanquished. So these are the feelings of our Lord. And this is also the feeling of our gurus, because they have same feelings as God. So Gurudeva will always help us in order to win. You must win, because Lord Krishna said, all his devotees will win. So it's very nice to live in such kind of thinking and feelings. to live with winners. To following the real winners. Winners who are really helpful, always helping. Because in this world, winners, they want to remain alone as the only winners. But in spiritual feelings, no. They want everybody to be a winner. So in this way, premanjana, we must do this exercise. Put love in your eyes. Wherever you see, we must sing, I must love. Everything. This insect, this mouse, this enemy. This is something that impressed me a lot when I read in Ramayana that there was this Rakshasas, no? And these sentient persons living in the forests practicing their process, spiritual process. And these Rakshasas, they came to eat them. And they allow it to be eaten. You want to eat me? Okay, eat me. I will not defend, because defense, this is animal attitude. So it is an attitude most difficult to, you know, to control. Don't to defend. So they were looking like this. Oh, this is the last test. Now this Rakshasa is coming and he would eat me. I must look at him with love. Because these sentient persons, they were so powerful that if they look with anger, the Rakshasa will be burned out. Immediately, the Rakshasa will be burned out. But they were not burned out, they were eating the sadhu. And the sadhu, he was becoming liberated. He was leaving this world as a real conqueror, real conqueror of all his animal propensities. It is very difficult not to be an animal. It is very easy to be an animal. And if we have enemies, we are still animals. We must follow Yudhishthira Maharaj. Ajatasattu has here. All these qualities, so nice. And this is the highest, I think, so. Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilo Charena Santa Sadaivari de Jesu Vilo Kayanti Santa, the sentient persons. They are seeing in everybody's hearts. Syama Sundar is there. Gan Syama Sundar Achintya Guna Swarupam. Achintya Guna. There is Syama Sundar. Yansamasundara, who is this Yamasundara? He is Achintyarupa, of incredible forms, beauty. Why he is so beautiful? Why he is Achintyarupa? Because he is full of qualities. Our most important quality is compassion. Haribol. And because we need this compassion, actually, we can say we only need compassion. We are in a very, very big need. Because at least me, I have no qualities. No qualities. So, your compassion, Vaishnava compassion, and Ishvara compassion, these are our hope, our real hope. And we can be full of this hope because Krishna is there, devotees are there. So Lord Krishna comes with his devotees. This means that he comes with all his potencies. I am an ocean of mercy, Krishna. He's an ocean of mercy, coming with a lot of ocean of mercy. Because this is Krishna's characteristic. Everything he's doing in a big way. So you are asking for mercy. Okay, I just bring the many, many oceans of mercy. Only a little drop from any of these oceans is sufficient. But in order to be sure, I bring all these oceans. So what these things are doing the sainted persons, Lord Ram is saying. Santa Sada. Santa means sainted persons. Sada means always. Santa Sadaiva, certainly always. Santa Vidayesu Virokayanti. Vidayesu means in all hearts. They are all always seeing at the heart of everybody. Dogs, cats, insects, trees, everyone. And Shyamasundar is there. Imagine. Incredible, so nice. So they are trying to awake our hearts. Our heart is now sleeping, is almost dead, because we have more interest in our brain, in our senses. Our heart is almost forgotten, our heart. Our eyes are looking after color and form. Our ears are looking after sound. Our nose is looking after smell. Like this. No? And our heart is looking after qualities. So nice. No? So our heart is bhakta. Our heart is for bhakti. So we must concentrate ourselves in our inner self. This means in your heart. Looking always for these qualities. And we were saying before, no? Humility is the first one, is the queen. Through humility and thanks to humility, we will ask for help. When we ask for help, we go to bhakti path. We take the bhakti path. Bhakti path means I cannot do it by myself. I only can be guided by all of you. Please come and help me. No? For example, if you want to be a doctor, engineer, architect, whatever you want. Musician, no? You must take a lot of teachers, professors. So in order to be a saintly person, we need so much help in order to reach the higher, the highest. So this is like this, no? Santa Sadaiva Ridayesu. Sada means always. They're always practicing this point. In 11th canto also, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says like this. you must always think that I am in everyone's heart. All along, Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said like this, second canto also. No, he says like this, no, all this, from here to here. I am in the hearts of everybody. This size. I am in everyone's heart. So, you are a temple. So, you must remain clean. You must remain bright, happy, confident, transcendental. The temple is a transcendental place. All these things are our duty. All these things are our paradharma. Paradharma means this. I must become transcendent. There's no other way. This must be our profession. And transcendental means this thing. To always love. To be everyone's friend. To live in our heart place. In the place of our heart. Something like no? From heart, situated in your heart, not in your brain, in your majestic brain, calculating how much can I take? We must think, how much can I give? What can I do for you? So they're always practicing like this. I read a yes, we look at Yanti, and they are very successful by doing this. We look at Yanti, they are seeing in everyone's hearts. Siama Sundara Machintya Guna Swarupa. Machintya Guna. Swarupa, Achintyaguna Swarupa. This is very nice, no? Lord Rama is defining Siamasun. Achintyaguna Swarupa. Surprising qualities. Okay, so we are beggars. We are begging for all these qualities and name, the holy name will give. Because in this holy name, in this holy Maha Mantra, Srimati Radharani is there present. Hare. Hare. Hare means take me out from here, please. Take me out from this dirty place. From this dirty place of my own desires. Material desires. Take me to your place. Please make me live. I'm not still living. I am like an embryo. This universe is womb. is a womb. Krishna says like this, Bhagavad Gita, 14th chapter, 14th 2 or 3, I was 14th 3 most. Mama Yoni Mahat Brahma. So we think ourselves big persons, but no. Yeah, 14.3. You still have even not took birth. You even not took birth. No? As Jesus Christ said, no? All of us, we are dead persons. Jesus Christ said. Because it is like embryo in mother's, in woman womb. Sometimes they say, oh, he's alive or he's not alive, the embryo. Because he's not moving, he's doing nothing. So maybe he's not alive. So you cannot, it is not so easy to know. So in the same way, we are here in this universal womb, but are we really living? Jesus said, no. You are not acting for the Lord. You are not serving the Lord. So you're not acting. No, or better to say, yes, your acts are not good. But activities. Okay, like this. So all along scriptures, they're always mentioning qualities. And as we were saying before, if we mention these qualities, they will come. You are calling them. Yatra yatra chamad bhakta prashanta samadarshina. How are my devotees? Lord Nisimha is saying, he is not describing them as, oh, my devotees, they have Kirtila, they have Kunti. No. Of course, also they have like this, but he goes more deep. Prashanta Samadarshi. Because any cheater, he can buy a Kunti, put on Tilak. But we must be Prashanta. Very peaceful. Very peaceful means also very satisfied. Very satisfied means very grateful. I am very grateful with my Lord. Prashanta Samadarshina. Sadava. Samaduchara. Sadava. Saintly persons. Sadhu. Sadhava, samudachara, samudachara means magnanimous, always trying to give, always trying to help, always giving light, enlivening, magnanimous, Hare Krishna. Maybe they have nothing, but as Srila Prabhupada, he arrived here with nothing and he came to give. So always magnanimous. Persons who are like this, Lord Nisimha is saying, Te Puyante, apikikata te puyanti pi te puyanti apikikata. Kikata means low countries. Countries very degraded, degraded places. No, filthy, filthy places. When Srila Prabhupada arrived here in the West, he said, Lord Krishna, why you bring me to this so filthy place, full of passion and ignorance? What can I do here? So, te puyanti vi kikata, te puyanti. They can purify. Excuse me, the world place, the world country. So imagine if you cannot be purify yourself, by sure you will be purify yourself. You will be purifying others. So even much you can purify yourself. Because it is like this. You ask for a drop of water and a rain comes. We are calling for a drop of mercy. In some way or other, we were calling for a drop of mercy. Sometimes suffering, asking, where is the truth? What is my duty in this world, in this life? What is my real dharma? We were asking here and there, there was no answer. And Srila Prabhupada, our masters, they came with all this shower, rain of mercy. You are looking only after a drop, and now you know so much about Krishna, his many forms, activities, and even more, you know, about Lord Chaitanya. As Srila Tripurari Maharaj said, you may read all Mahabharata, you may read all Srimad Bhagavatam, and maybe you will know nothing about Lord Chaitanya. But if you know about Lord Chaitanya, by sure you will know about Krishna. So, Lord Krishna, he's hidden, we can say, Lord Chaitanya, because Lord Chaitanya is a hidden incarnation. He's a thief. He's the most powerful thief, stealing Radharani's heart. So he was preparing, no? Lord Krishna, he was preparing his next theft. He was preparing, so I cannot speak about Lord Chaitanya. Now everybody knows that I am a thief in Vrindavan. Everybody knows that I am a thief, but they don't know about my bigger robe, theft, my bigger theft. I'm preparing. So this is Mahaprabhu. And we know about this Mahaprabhu. Incredible. Sometimes I think that when Sri Krishna says, Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam, this is the king of all knowledge, and this is Raja Guhyam, this is the king of all secrets. So Mahaprabhu is this Raja Guhyam. Sometimes I think like this. The bigger, the highest secrets. All these things I will be revealed. Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam Pavitra Amida Mutam. Pavita, when we will be purified, Idamutam, all these superior things will come out to light. Pratyaksha Bhagavyan Dharmya, Pratyaksha Bhagavyan, you will see Pratyaksha. You will see these things, all these things. Please come to this path. This is Krishna's conclusion in this sloka. Please come to this joyous, happy path. Don't be afraid. Hare Bol, Hare Krishna. Thank you. Well, now I must confess because we always hear about the 26 qualities that the devotees develop. So. Yesterday I tried to write a song about these 26 qualities. Well, I confess I feel some shame, you know. I feel I'm ashamed. But I will try to sing this song. About the 26 qualities, it was a surprise. I will put in the chat the letter of the song. It is in English and then it is in Spanish also. Please have a good time. Have a look, big lot. How you call this? Lot of log. Log, no? Log. Lot of. No. Lol. Now you may have some lol. No, it's not. No. Hare Krishna. Uy. Okay. I will try now. To sing this, Yes, Lord. Here now. Hare Krishna. Okay, I will try now. 1, 2, 3. My dear devotees, please hear about the 26 qualities that through bhakti we must reach as Sri Krishna Kaviraj will teach. All of us, we must be compassive, without any enemy, truthful, equal to everyone, free from faults, magnanimous smile, always clean, dispossessed, seeking everyone's benefit, peaceful, surrender to our Lord, free from material desires, meek, steady, control, not eating more than required, not affected by illusion, respecting everyone, humble, grave, merciful, friendly, poetic, skillful, and silent. O divine goddess, bhakti, please be merciful, give me these qualities. Let me serve the devotees of your Lord. Give me a place as your kind lotus feet. O divine goddess, bhakti, please be merciful, give me these qualities. Let me serve the devotees of your Lord. Give me a place at your kind lotus feet. Give me a place at your kind lotus feet. What Manandi? Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. Well,
thank again, you very much.
No, it was a try, una, ¿cómo se dice? Un intento. Okay, thank you very much. Many thanks to Srila Tripurari Maharaj and all of you who were accompanying these lectures about bhakti qualities. Well, to do my best, but I am not so much prepared, no, but I try to do something. thank you very much. Well, I don't know if there is some question, or we can finish here. No? Haribo. Gracias. Thank you for well, thank you very much, Kali Yuga Pavana Mitra Prabhu, by your translation, and thanks again to all of you for staying here, supporting all these things. Jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Vaishnavrinda ki jai, Gopamanandi, Gopamanandi, thanks a lot. Hari Bol.
Jai Gurudeva Dandavat, thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thanks to you.
Jai Srila Bhakti Kavya Atulananda Charya Swami Ki. Jai.
Jai, Gorpramanani, Gorpramanani, thank you, thank you. Dandavat, Pancha Kalpataru Yachakari Pasindu Vyavacha, Paditanam Pavanevi, Vaishnavevi, Namo Namaha. Thank you, thank you, thanks to you, to all of you. Haribol, Haribol, Aiso Vaishnavas, como Oceanos de Piedad. Ya, damos muchas reverencias. Haribol, Jai.